You probably want to avoid this kind of foam rolling because, first of all, there is no point of rolling the IT band up and down like that because it's not gonna change. No matter what you do, it's not gonna change. Hi guys, I'm Enjoy. Welcome back to my channel, Mr.Physio here in Australia. As mentioned in the last video about gluteal tendinopathy, today's topic is IT band and TFL. If you haven't watched my last video, please go and watch, especially if you're a woman. Even if you're a guy, I can assure you it's definitely worth your time because I've seen many gym guys and sports players having weakness in their side hips and a lot of problems happen from there. And we can't talk about IT band without gluteus medius, and I will tell you why. We're gonna go through four things today: its function, how it gets tight, and what happens if it's tight, and the solutions. So let's get it. As always, let's have a look at the anatomy. IT band is a thick band attached to both gluteus maximus, that's our hip muscle, and TFL, short for tensor fascia lata. IT band covers the head of a thigh bone called greater trochanter, where the gluteus medius and minimus muscles are attached. If you have watched my last video, you can already know what can go wrong because of that. I will get back to this later. So IT band itself is not a muscle, and it doesn't have any function. Instead, we need to look at the functions of TFL and gluteus maximus that's attached to IT band. So TFL is attached here around your front pocket like this. So it is in line with the, thigh bone. And when it contracts, the main function of the muscle is lifting your leg out to the side, right out to the side this way, like this, which is called hip abduction. And second function is internal rotation of the thigh bone. So when you look at the IT band, it starts from here, going all the way down, attached on the outer side of the knee. So it's below the knee. So if this long structure gets shortened with the TFL contracting, that will just push the knee inwards. That's why if you have tension on the IT band, your knee is likely to go in. And that's the main function of the TFL too. So if it contracts, that will actually bring your knee inwards, which is internal rotation of the thigh bone. So thigh bone rolls in. Also, upper part of gluteus maximus assists the hip abduction movement. So together, they account for 20 or 30% of the hip abduction power. Gluteus maximus is attached like that, and some of the fibers attached on the IT band. So upper part of the gluteus maximus assists that, hip abduction movement, bringing your leg out to the side because it is in line with the thigh bone. But the other fibers attached like this, most of the fibers, attached to diagonally this way. So if it contracts, that's bringing your leg backwards like that, and then rotating your leg out to the side. So taking your leg back and rotating out this way. So this is TFL and this is upper part of the gluteus maximus, and together they assist that hip abduction movement, and at the same time they work against each other. One's bringing your leg inwards that way, and the other one's bringing your leg backwards and rotating out. So this rotation, TFL and gluteus maximus. So how does it get tight? First of all, gluteus maximus weakness. So when you sit down, you put the TFL into a shortened position, and gluteus maximus is relatively being stretched out because it gets squashed like that. So if you actually stay in that position for a long time, this muscle is likely to get shortened and overactive, and the other muscle will get lengthened and underactive or weak. All right? And I just told you they work against each other. So if one side is short and tight, overactive, it can inhibit the function of the other side. And the second reason is gluteus medius. Gluteus medius and minimus account for 60-70% of the hip abduction power, and the TFL and the upper part of the gluteus maximus accounts for 20 or 30%. So if the hip muscles, gluteus medius and minimus, and including maximus, are weak, TFL has to work harder. But is the TFL strong enough to do that? Of course not. So if these hip abductors are weak, they can't stabilize your pelvis, dropping the other hip down. In this picture, if the left hip goes down, the right IT band will be stretched out more, which will increase its tension. The last one is vastus lateralis, one of the quadriceps muscles, which sits under the IT band. So this is the thigh muscle and the IT band sits on top of it. And imagine your IT band is already tightened up because of the weak glutes. Then it will compress the vastus lateralis like this. But many people already have hypertrophy or overactivation in that, you know, vastus lateralis muscle. So IT band itself will be a little bit more stretched out like that, which will increase the tension on the IT band. So what happens if it's tight? So IT band itself doesn't get tight. The problem is the TFL. TFL gets tight first, and that will increase the tension on the IT band. So if the TFL gets tight or overactive, it does this internal rotation of the thigh bone, rotating your thigh inwards and putting your knee in, and a lot of stress on the gluteus medius. And it was mentioned in the last video, compression and stretching around that hip area can cause the gluteus medius problem. And since the IT band goes over the greater trochanter, the bony area here, it can add more compression on the tendons of the gluteus medius and minimus. So you've got head of the thigh bone, and on top of that, you've got gluteus medius and minimus tendon attached like this. And then you've got IT band on top of it. So this soft tissue, this tendon of the muscles, can be rubbed against the bony area and the tight IT band. So it can be rubbed like that all the time. And exactly the same thing can happen down here. IT band gets rubbed against the bony area. For example, when you run, if you don't have strong hip muscles, you know, or if they get tired at the end of the run, your knee starts to go in, putting a lot of stress here or there. It can also happen without your knee going in. In this picture, the right hip goes down, which means the left hip is weak. You can see the right knee is a lot lower than left knee. And then the left side of the IT band will be stretched out. So you can pretty much say IT band syndrome is caused by IT band being stretched out. So you don't need to do stretching, you don't need to do massaging on the IT band as well. And when you do cycling with both knees in and doing this kind of action, and that's already internal rotation, and TFL is in a shortened position, it can get overactive. So you're using the TFL a lot, increasing the tension on the IT band, and IT band can be rubbed here and there. Therefore, the solution is to loosen up tight muscles and strengthen up the weak muscles in a functional way. The first muscle to loosen up is TFL. So it sits like that around the front pocket area, about, you know, 10 to 15 centimeter. So you put the ball around the front pocket and push against the wall. So if you move your body side to side like that, slowly, you can find a painful spot and just massage there for about 30 seconds, like that way. And you can go all the way down on the side of the thigh to do the vastus lateralis release. So this is the side of the thigh, a little bit forward, and just put the ball against the wall and just rolling like that. Or I've shown you some elbow release, you know, sitting on a chair and with your elbow and just rolling through the muscles here. And vastus lateralis is attached on the back of the IT band as well. So put the ball and sit down like that, maybe press down. You can do it on the ground and doing all the way down here. You probably want to avoid this kind of foam rolling because first of all, there is no point of rolling the IT band up and down like that because it's not gonna change. No matter what you do, it's not gonna change. And second reason is there is a compression component applied to the bony area, side of the hip. So that's not good for the gluteus medius. Especially when you have gluteus medius problem, don't do this kind of foam rolling. And the last one is gluteus maximus, the hip muscle. So you just push against the ball and just rolling side to side. It's just gentle pressure up and down about 30 seconds. And for the exercises, we're gonna work on your hip muscles again. What I mean by functional way is you're gonna use that muscles in a similar way you would use in normal activities, like walking, running. So in the last video, we did the hip hitch, and you're gonna do the same thing. So hitch up your hip against the wall, and then you're going to push yourself away from the wall. Pushing, pushing, but you're going to resist by lifting your hip up like that. You don't need to lift too high, just 1 centimeter is enough so that your pelvis can be level rather than dropping like this and causing a lot of stress here. So lift, hitch up your hip about a couple of centimeters and push yourself away from the wall, but you're resisting by pushing your hip that way.
So it's exactly the same exercise shown in the last video.
And then we're gonna do the same thing, just toe taps going up and down, up and down. And if you can do the small taps, you can go a little bit wider, back and forth, hip swings, and you should feel like burning sensation here on the side hip. After that, you can use a pillow to do more dynamic movements like walking and running pattern. So in this exercise, pushing the pillow against the wall a little bit, you don't need to push too hard, putting more weight onto the outer side of the foot and keeping your knees in line with your toes or out to the side a little bit so that it doesn't come in. That's important, remember? And then keeping the pelvis level the whole time. So when you think of it, your hip has to be stabilized every time you take a step through. So we are training that hip muscles to be able to do that. Okay, to sum up, IT band problem is very much related to gluteus muscles. So you need to work on your gluteus muscles in a functional way. And it may be pointless working directly on IT band because IT band is not the problem. In fact, your TFL gets overactive and tight, and that increases the tension on the IT band. So if you stretch out your IT band, it may, make it worse. I hope this video helps. I'll see you next time. 안전 조절.
사실 다리 근육은 우리가 평소에 쓰는 그대로 운동해 주는 게 최고입니다.